Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Cards of Life. In today's video I'm going to show you how to make rechado masala or red masala, which you can use in Goan cuisine in different dishes. The only way, you have to add different ingredients in different dishes. So this is the basic masala what I'm going to show you today in today's video, and then you can add in, you can make sorpatel, you can make fish rechado, you can make pork admas or vindaloo, whatever, the choice is all yours. This is the basic masala what I'm going to show you today in today's video. So let's get started. For the rechado masala, the main thing you need is a blender. So what we do in 2020, since we are in 2020, we use an electric blender. In ancient times or traditional, we had a grinder of this kind. You'll be surprised, this is a small one, of course, and the one which my grandmother used to use was a bigger one. Even one person cannot lift it. So this is just a demo what I'm showing you. So this is a grinder, a rock grinder, and now I'm going to use an electric blender, which is going to make things quick. So what I'm going to do this, what I've done over here is I've soaked the red chilies in vinegar for around 2 hours, which helps the chilies to get soft and absorb all the vinegar, and we add in to the blender. A small piece of ginger, 6 to 8 cloves of garlic. The more the garlic, the better the taste. Peppercorns. Small pieces of cinnamon, which will help to grind faster. 6 to 10 cloves. A teaspoon of cumin. You can use cumin powder instead of cumin, and which will give you a smooth paste. Half a teaspoon of turmeric powder as well. Over here what I've done is I've taken one onion, I've sliced it thinly and sauteed in oil with little bit of sugar to get it caramelized, and which will give you a earthy texture or burnt texture or taste. Previously we used to do it in the charcoal. You have to burn the charcoal and throw in the onion and to get it caramelized. So now, say in modern times, we are doing it in the pan, and a small piece of palm jaggery. If you don't find palm jaggery, you can add sugar, but you'll not get that burnt taste to your masala. And since I had added vinegar to the chilies, I'm adding half a cup of vinegar to it. If you see, I have not added water to it. If you add water, your masala gets spoiled very fast. And if you do it with full vinegar, you can keep it for months without refrigeration. You can just leave it outside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to blend it now to a fine paste. Take out all the masala into a bowl and I'm going to taste it now. Wow, the spice from the chili and the spices, the tanginess from the vinegar and the sweetness from the jaggery. That's the combination, and the rechado masala is right in front of you. My mouth is already watering.